This lady, whose identity has been concealed, says she took a yellow fever vaccine shot at Entebbe International Airport a year ago.
I was forced to take the vaccine at the airport. I actually tried to tell the people who were at the airport that I'm HIV positive.
She experienced side effects. She's amongst many who are being forced to take the shot.
My problem is I've been getting this headache, consistent headache, like persistent headache. I have flu every time. And the doctor was giving me like medicine every time. Then the doctor had to ask me, why doesn't this flu go away? Then I told him, they injected me. I don't know whether it's a side effect of the injection. And even the headache, I actually discussed it with the doctor. Then the doctor told me, did you tell them that you're HIV positive?
The International Community of Women Living with HIV and AIDS Eastern Africa has petitioned the Minister of Health to intervene.
In the end, cause other problems in the body of an HIV positive person. We want the government to come out clearly with a statement that that really guides the provision of the vaccine.
Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Health, Dr Asuman Lukwago, told NTV that there is a medical evidence that shows that the vaccine causes some side effects.
Live vaccines, which are weakened, we call them live attenuated or active attenuated. Those ones can flare up an infection of the vaccine-related infection in immune-compromised people. So in HIV people, we tend to ask some questions about the level of disease. We have the staging of HIV. If our patient is like equivalent to someone who could be having CD4 cell count below 200, those have some risks of getting some side effects after vaccination.
Research conducted by the Center for Disease Control shows that the vaccine can suppress body immunity.
Virus which is weakened goes into the body. It can't cause diseases, but it will make the body wake up, produce antibodies or cells that are prepared to attack a future virus in case the body is infected. So in HIV, because of the low immunity, that robust response to the vaccine is lowered, is blunted by the HIV infection. But if the immunity is very, very low, the weakened virus in the vaccine may flare up into a disease which you are intending to stop, and then it develops.
Less than 200.
And my CD4 count is 1,900. That was last year. And this year they tested me, my viral load was undetectable.
If during the assessment they find out that this one is severely immunocompromised, we can waive off on the vaccine, depending on the risk which the patient can get.
Just getting a whole batch of people living with HIV and just vaccinating them with a live attenuated vaccine is not good. Everybody should be considered at their stage where they are at the moment when they need the vaccine. And that's a medical point of view.
Currently, the government is undertaking a yellow fever vaccination program in the country. Dr. Lukwago says all Ugandans are required to take the vaccine, including HIV and AIDS patients. He's advising patients to report all symptoms emerging from the ongoing yellow fever vaccination exercise so that the health experts can offer treatment.
So that they can reveal whatever they could be suffering from. Some of them could be on chronic medication, anti-cancers, or they could have started their ARVs.
The activists raised the red flag ahead of the HIV and AIDS International Conference in Durban, South Africa next month, where they are required to be vaccinated before they travel. Jingo Francis, NTV.